Geneva, Tuesday. $2 billion for Yemen.
It is my pleasure to announce that this pledging conference represents a remarkable success of international solidarity to the people of Yemen.
New York, just a week ago, $1 billion for Yemen. The amounts are staggering, but this is not the first time the suffering of Yemen have been offered the world's help. But how does aid pass through a violent civil war and the airstrikes and missiles of a proxy war to reach the victims of violence, famine and cholera, especially if those offering the help are making matters worse?
Probably from the Saudis it may have been sincere, but it has so many limitations on it that its ability to really address the humanitarian crisis is going to be extremely limited and has been discounted by a number of the major international aid organizations. In the beginning, I think there was an assumption that the Saudis were hitting civilian targets like schools and hospitals by accident. After 3 years, I think there is a growing concern that these institutions are being hit on purpose.
And their adversary, Iran, is using Yemen's ports for anything but aid. Former UK Foreign Minister David Miliband heads International Rescue, one of the few NGOs to operate in Yemen.
To travel from Aden to Sana'a, which many of you will know is a distance of about 300 miles, we have to pass through more than 70 checkpoints. That's an average of one checkpoint every 4.3 miles. It takes my teams 3 to 6 weeks of planning and permitting to get one truck on the road from Aden to Sana'a.
Miliband knows this kind of crisis firsthand, but has never seen suffering on Yemen's scale. Can you tell me what the most urgent humanitarian need is?
The most urgent is obviously the life-saving work. So you've got children dying at such a alarming rate. That has to be the priority. We have mobile health teams who try and address those kind of issues. The acute level of suffering that is suffered by some Yemenis is not unique. What is unusual is the fact that it encompasses nearly 80% of the whole country, 22 million people out of 27. In Yemen, you have state fragility layered with conflict, layered with long-term climate resource stress, layered with poverty, makes it very, very difficult.
The United Nations talks of a peace process, appointing a new envoy, but without safe passage and a conflicted guarantor, the world's forgotten war is far from over. Nina Larsen, I-24 News, Washington.